When you're doing a photo walk or travel photography or street photography and you set up a tripod, you might as well put on a shirt, say, "Police, come to me. Tell me not to do this." A security guard, a police officer, anyone's gonna run up and say, "Don't do that." I don't know what happened to the world and why they think like tripods are now a terrorist instrument, but it's the reality that we live in. So my secret is this, the Platypod. Now, for street photography, I actually, and with the camera lens that I have, I use this one, which is the Platypod Ultra. Now, the Ultra is very, very small. It is lightweight, and it literally fits in your pocket. Now, here's how it works. You take a ball head, and you screw it into it. So it looks like this. This is the plate. I'm gonna show you the plate because I talk about how small it is. When I say it fits in your pocket, it literally fits in your pocket. And when you want to take it out, you reach in, and there it is right there. It's so small, it's lightweight, it's made of this aircraft aluminum. And it's got all kinds of little holes and notches and stuff so you can do cool things with it. You'll see me do a couple of these here just as I go through this. But this has changed my photography. If you're doing street photography, if you're on the photo walk, if you're doing travel photography, you gotta have one of these. Now, what it does, you take this and you screw a ball head into it. So it has a little screw right on the top of it. This literally just screws right on top of it, like that. Then your camera slots right on top of that. You lock it in, and this is my rig. Now, I will tell you this. I use a Black Rapid Classic strap, and it screws right into the bottom of this. So I walk around the city like this. It's already put together. I don't stop and put it together, because it's so lightweight. The only thing you're really adding is the weight of the ball. You won't even notice the weight of the Platypod, it's so small. You're just gonna notice the ball head, that's it. That's the only weight that's gonna add anything to it. Now, I'm using an Oben, what is this, the BE-117? Yes, it is the Oben BE-117, which is a wonderful, I mean, it's almost like it's made for it. In fact, if you go to B&H Photo, they sell a bundle of the BE-117 and the Platypod together as a bundle, because I found that that's just such a great thing that I told them, you gotta sell these together because they're like made for each other. Now, so this is how I walk around with it at my side. I wanna take a picture, I just shoot it, I keep this on there. But all of a sudden, I'm in a really cool place. Like, take a look here, I'm inside where? The Vatican, yeah. And so I take my camera, and I aim it up. Now, there's this little barrier there that I put it on, but look how small it is. Now, by the way, you set up a tripod in the Vatican, I happen to know that they have snipers up in the, no, probably not. But I can tell you, you set up a tripod, you will have security on you, yep. You won't even get the second leg out before they're like, "You can't do that here." Oh, they would have a fit. But I put it up, and literally, security guard walks by, he looks at it, just keeps going. You know how many security guards saw me using my, and nobody cared a lick. So look, here's the shot. So here's the behind the scenes and here's the actual shot. All right, but the one that always floors people is this one. They're like, "How did you get that with nobody there in that low perspective?" I got there early. I was in line a half or an hour or 45 minutes before the doors opened in the morning. So I was like the first one in, right? Now, I thought, I'm gonna get there like, I don't know, 5:30, 6 in the morning, whatever it is. There'll be nobody there, it'll be 3 people in line. There were 200 people in front of me. So why don't I see any people in my shots? That church is so big, 200 people, looks like there's nobody there. It looks empty, it's the biggest thing. You could take Notre Dame and stick it in it probably 6 or 7 times. It's massive. So what I do with my camera is literally I walked up to that line and I just sat it there. Security guards walk by, they don't say a word. Remember the shot that I showed you earlier from that bridge? That's it. I'm using that same rig right there on the bridge, and I'm getting shots where other people are trying to handhold indoors and stuff. Mine is steady as a rock. But the thing about the low angle that's so great is it makes the floor highly reflective. You can see the floor there. It doesn't look that reflective, but not only does it make it reflective, but it gives you this epic look. So here's the shot taken from that. And you can just stick it anywhere. Here I'm in a library. I stick it on a table and bang. And look how reflective the table looks now. It's kind of a weird thing. All right, so I just wanted to turn you on to that. That is one of my secret weapons. I take it everywhere and I've become an evangelist for it because I just love it so much.